Oh, I could use a distraction.
Keeping that clean.
That's a keeper.
That looks amazing. What else was there?
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half-god and half-giant? Weird.
Once Björgun was gone, lonely ages passed. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted beneath his bluster. You know what? I'll tell this one later.
That's why he was always at war?
Nothing quite so simple. But I hoped that love might temper him and give us a chance for peace. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes I can scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. He won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. And we'll pick this up later.
Behind you!
Tyr's braziers, a symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes, though?
Now you mention it, he wouldn't.
We've seen these runes before, but it's the kind I still can't read. Hiding behind there.
No earthly key nor physical force can get past the magic of that lock. Don't even look at it.
What's that down there? Freya could have been happy, but he only wanted her magic?
Aye.
You know what?
I'll tell this one later.
So Odin and Freya could have been happy, but he only wanted her magic?
Aye. A taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy,
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Good. The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
scared of that.
This realm suffers without my spirit.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out,
look
while
if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek. What is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night. So far, far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. I know. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty clawbag just got lucky.
Hostile. A wolver!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together. Ready yourself, boy!
Magically sealed, I'm afraid.
Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
This is locked up good.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Enemies.
Wolver behind you, brother!
Atreus, follow me.
You're right there. And I'll find Light Crystal. I wonder what it's for.
Thank you.
modern world trees there. That's handy. Well, here's the base for the crystal we saw. But how do we get it down?
What does it say?
To Njord, we offer back the sea's bounty.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
Can we go through? How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Right.
I'll knock him out!